Welcome back to my channel. Today I have brought for you all a very interesting sweet dish recipe. It is the gulab jamuns. These gulab jamuns are homemade and they are made right from scratch. So hope so you all will like this recipe of mine. And so without wasting any much time, let's get started with the recipe. So now for the preparation of the homemade gulab jamuns, we'll be preparing the gulab jamuns right from scratch. That preparing the mawa, everything at home, we are not using any market mawa. So for that, now first I'll be adding half a cup of milk to this non-stick pan. Guys, use a non-stick pan only, because and if the milk or the other ingredients get stuck, then we'll get a burnt texture for the gulab jamun, which will not taste at all good. So preferably a non-stick pan is used. So now into this milk we have to add 1/4 cup of pure ghee. Use pure ghee, guys, because it will give a nice taste to our gulab jamuns. So first we'll be adding 1/4 cup of pure ghee for it. And now we have to just mix this ghee along with this milk a little bit. And now into this we'll be adding 1.5 cup of milk powder. It is approximately 200 grams. So we'll add all this little by little. And we'll keep on stirring, because we don't need any lumps. We want a lump-free mixture. So we'll add little at a time and we'll keep on stirring this very nicely. Also clean the sides from the dry powder and put it in the center. Till now we have not kept it on the gas. It is off gas, because first we have to mix everything very well. And now here, as you all can see, it is a lump-free mixture. So now we will put it on the fire. On low flame we have to keep it now, and we have to go on stirring it. So now here I have kept it on the fire and it is on low flame. And now we have to keep on stirring it till this thing thickens up nicely, like a dough. It will take approximately 5 to 7 minutes for that consistency to get, the doughy consistency. So we have to keep on stirring it and have patience with it. Now guys, it is looking very loose, but not to worry about it. We will get a consistency of a doughy consistency after 5 minutes of continuous stirring, and that you all will also be able to see. So now here guys, as you all can see, it has all come together like a dough. But still we'll just cook it for another 2 minutes. And here the instant khoya of ours, or mawa, is ready. So now we have to keep it for cooling. But don't cool it down completely. When it is a little warm only, we have to start working on it. So now I will be switching off the flame. And here I'll keep it for cooling for some time. So now here, I'll take it out into this thing and we'll leave it for cooling. But see that you don't leave it to cool completely, because it has to be warm when we are going to make the gulab jamuns. So now guys, this mash has become a little bit warm. It is still warm. So to this we'll be adding now 4 tablespoons of maida, that is all-purpose flour, and 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. So this we'll have to now knead this along with this nicely. So now, before preparing the gulab jamuns, I have kept some oil for heating, for frying of the gulab jamuns. And now we'll proceed to prepare the chutney for the gulab jamuns. For that, I have taken a vessel, and into that I'll be adding 3 cups of sugar, 1.5 cup of water. Now we have to make this chutney. We don't want 1 tar or 2 tar. We just want the sugar to get melted, and it should and the texture should be like ghee texture on the hand, when we little sticky texture on the hand. Only that type of chutney we require. So we'll just proceed to now melt the sugar. So now here our dough is ready for the gulab jamuns. So we'll take some ghee on our palms. Take a portion from this. How big you all want, you all can have keep the gulab jamun, and we'll make it form a round ball shape now. This gulab jamun should be crack free. Otherwise, in the oil when we start frying, it will break up there. So it should be crack free. So take care of that and just roll it into a nice round shaped ball. Gulab jamun is ready, so we'll prepare all the gulab jamun in the same way. So now here our sugar syrup is ready. We have to test it up like this. We have to take it on our finger a little bit here, and we have to just feel it as if it is nice and sticky, and this is sticky. So our syrup is ready. So into this now we'll be adding 8 to 10 cardamoms powder I have made, and we'll add that to this. So it will give a nice flavor to the gulab jamuns and a nice taste also. And now we will switch off the flame, because our chutney is ready. So now for the frying of the gulab jamuns, I'll just test it first if the oil is okay. So I have put the small ball and nothing is happening. So let the oil become a little bit more hot. And when we have to just this. So I'll just let this ball get fried. It is not getting fried at all. Yes, it has come up. So the oil is okay now for frying of the gulab jamuns. So we'll add some gulab jamuns now. So here I'll be dropping some of the gulab jamuns now inside the hot oil. Don't crowd the vessel up, guys. I have just put 6, and now with the help of a spoon we have to just rotate the oil so that the gulab jamuns also turn a little bit and they don't get stuck down at the bottom. So we have to just shake the oil literally. And we have to fry these gulab jamuns till they are nice golden brown in color. Light golden brown in color. Don't make them too dark. So guys, as you all can see, the gulab jamuns are turning a little bit brown. So we'll wait for another 2 minutes before we remove this batch out. So now the gulab jamuns are ready. So here I've taken a strainer for draining of the excess of oil into the pan itself. So we'll just put our gulab jamuns into that. So all the excess oil will fall off. We have to directly drop them into this chutney what we have prepared, and let them remain. syrup into them. So now this gulab jamun, we'll leave it for 1 hour in this sugar syrup for soaking, and after that we'll be having it. So here the delicious looking gulab jamuns are ready. They are so tempting and they are so mouth watering, guys. I will just show you all one. See guys, how so soft and so yummy they have become. As you put them in the mouth, they just get melted. So guys, hope so you like this recipe of mine, and if so, do give this recipe a try and enjoy this yummy and tempting gulab jamuns with your family. Also please guys, subscribe to this family of ours and also hit the bell notification so that you all can get notified each time I post a new video. Also don't forget to like this video and share this recipe with your family, friends, relatives. I will see you all in my next video with another interesting and mouth-watering recipe. Till then, take care, stay safe, bye-bye.